Hello and welcome to today's video, the top 5 foundation types that can be used in any shipping container house and building. Good, welcome back. Just like any other building, you need a suitable foundation for your shipping container house project. If you love shipping container homes or you are exploring the possibilities of building your own, this video brings to you the top 5 foundation types used in any shipping container house or building. Stay tuned to find out more as we outline to you where and how each foundation can be used. In addition, we are highlighting the advantages and disadvantages of each foundation type. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for our weekly videos on shipping container home design. The first foundation type we are looking at is a pier foundation. A pier is basically a block of concrete or steel that is used to elevate the shipping containers off from the ground or from water. The size of your concrete piers or your steel piers will depend on the load-bearing capacity of the soil where you want to build and also on the sizes and the amount of containers you want to support. So the piers are placed at each of the corners of the shipping containers, and if you are using a 40-foot shipping container, you can add intermediate piers to support the container and prevent it from sagging in the middle. What are the advantages and disadvantages of a concrete pier or a steel pier foundation? Number one, it is the simplest, the cheapest, and the quickest foundation to use. Yeah, basically what you need to do is to put up your piers and space them according to the size of shipping containers you are using or according to the size of the house you want to build. Secondly, it is the most friendly shipping container foundation for DIY projects. You don't need any specialized skills. Thirdly, it saves on time and money because there's no sophistication that is required, and also it takes quite a little time to put them up. Fourthly, there are no specialized equipments that are required, nor do you need any specialized skills. This is why it is suitable for a DIY project. Lastly, but not least, we can say there's little excavation that is required. On the other hand, the disadvantages that come with this particular kind of foundation include: one, it is only ideal for small projects. Another disadvantage, you'll find that it has a lot of wasted space on the underside. Next, we look at the case studies. We have several case studies from around the world, so we look at two. One is the Containers of Hope in Chile. Another case study we can look at is the Beach House Budina. Beach House Budina is located in Brisbane, Australia, and they've used steel piers to elevate the shipping containers off the ground. In our own shipping container house projects by Shelter Mode Homes, we've done quite a number. You are free to explore our YouTube channel and you'll find out quite a number of projects that we've done using concrete pier foundations. The next type of foundation we want to look at is the raft foundation. Raft foundation is also known as a slab foundation. Yeah, this type of foundation is best for soft ground and it spreads the load across a large surface area. So generally you'll find that you need to have a larger footprint than the size of the house you want to put up. For example, if you want to put up a shipping container house project using a 40-foot shipping container, which measures 2.5 meters wide by 12 meters long, you'll have to extend the size of your footprint by a foot on both sides, prevent your shipping container from hanging off your slab foundation. One thing you need to note is you need to observe the standard concreting procedures. Once your slab has acquired the required strength, Then the next procedure is to bring your shipping container modules as per your design and place them on the slab. Mark out the proper locations for each container module and place them accordingly. The advantages of a raft foundation include: 1. It is ideal and suitable for unstable or what you would call soft soils. This type of foundation is also good for big projects. Yeah, you can use it for big projects because you only need to bring your container modules and arrange them on the slab as per the design of your house. Yeah, another advantage is we don't have wasted space on the underside as compared to a pier foundation. Yeah, it is also good in areas or in locations that are termite prone because there will be no space for termite to at least form or for animals to perch. The disadvantages of this particular foundation include: 1, there's a lot of excavation that is required. So you find that it might be a bit expensive compared to a pier foundation. Lastly, you'll find that there'll be a bit of difficulty when you are fixing utilities because there's no space between the container modules and the slab. So this is one disadvantage that comes with this particular kind of foundation. So you need to fix your utilities when you are casting your slab to avoid any complications. So what are the case studies we can look at as far as the raft foundation is concerned? Case study we can look at is one of our own shipping container house project by Sheltermont Homes. It's called Dwell Box 1600. This is a shipping container house project designed using 10 20-foot shipping containers to create a 1600 plus square foot house. So we basically did a slab over a large surface area as indicated, and we placed our container modules as shown, and we also stacked on top another 4 shipping containers to create this amazing house design. Our third type of foundation we are looking at is called a pile foundation. A pile foundation is used when the soil type is too weak to support a pier foundation or a concrete slab foundation. Yeah, in this particular type of foundation, you find that piles, which are generally cylindrical, are driven into the ground through the soft soil until you reach a more suitable load-bearing ground. Once you have secured in place all your piles, you need to cap the top of all the piles using either a concrete slab. You can also use concrete pads, or you use concrete beams to tie up all the piles so that you can have a rigid structure ready to receive your shipping containers. Once that is done, then you can bring your containers and place them on top of your pile. The first advantage is that it is very good and conducive to use on swampy soils that cannot support either a raft foundation or a pier foundation. If you live in areas that experience perennial flooding, so you need to move from your house once the flood waters subside, then you can relocate, then this would be an ideal type of foundation to use. Yeah. It is also good and ideal for big projects. The good thing also about this particular type of foundation is that there is ease in fixing of utilities because there's space in between the ground and also the underside of the slab. So you are able to fix your plumbing fixtures without much hindrance. So what are the disadvantages we can look at as far as a pile foundation is concerned? This type of foundation is the most expensive foundation type you can use for your shipping container house project. Why? Because it needs specialized equipment and skills to execute. Once that is done, you will need to either cover the entire set of piles using a slab, which might be reinforced concrete slab, or you use beams, which might be reinforced concrete beams, or you use pads, which are generally reinforced concrete. Another disadvantage is that the underside space of this particular foundation is just generally wasted space. So you have to be very creative on how you can use this particular space. So looking at one of our projects, the Shelter Box 320, We've managed to use the underside of this particular project by creating a carport, or if you want to create a garage, you just need to cover up all the sides and put a garage door, depending on the weather and the climate of your location. Another thing you can do with this particular wasted space is to create an outdoor living room, or an underside children's playroom, or a nice space for your pool table or your tennis table. What are the case studies we can look at as far as this particular foundation type is concerned? One very ubiquitous project that has been done using this particular type of foundation is the Graceville Container House in Australia. The fourth foundation type we'll look at is called a strip foundation. A strip foundation is also known as a trench foundation. Yeah, it is simply a 1 foot wide, 4 foot deep strip of concrete which is laid to carry your shipping containers. Yeah, this can be done just as we do a traditional strip foundation for your concrete or your brick or your stone wall house, but now you have to look at the weight of your shipping containers. If you are using many shipping containers, then it means the weight will be quite big, and therefore you need to increase the sizes of the thickness of your strip foundation, and also of the base of your strip foundation has to be increased. The good thing about this, you can also use different materials to do your strip foundation. You can do a ledge stone using quarry stones, or use stone blocks and mortar to create an elevated wall that can be used to carry your shipping containers, or you use stone gabions on both sides so that you can elevate your shipping containers from the ground. So the first advantage is that this particular foundation is ideal for stable grounds. It is also good for both small and big projects. Another advantage is that a strip foundation is a cheaper alternative to a slab foundation. It is also ideal for damp soils, as I indicated earlier, because when you use materials like stone gabions, it will allow you to drain all the water from the underside without creating any waterlogging on the underside of your house. This one is also good for basement spaces. So if you want to put up a shipping container house project with a basement, then look no further. This is the type of foundation you need to use. What are the disadvantages of a strip foundation? A strip foundation is bad for earthquake-prone locations because it will crack, and therefore this will bring a danger to your shipping container house project. It is also difficult to fix utilities, because once your shipping containers cover the entire strip of your house, then fixing of utilities would be a problem. Another thing is that you'll find that if you have your strip covering all the four sides of your shipping container, then you have a wasted space on the underside. A good case study is a project we've done by Shelter Mod Home that is called Loftbox 1280. Loftbox 1280 is a good case study because this was an ingenious way of increasing the floor area of this particular house. So we decided to use a strip foundation whereby we build two ledge stone walls on the opposite sides or opposite ends of shipping containers, and we lifted them up a floor higher and placed them on top of our stone ledges. This did two things. One, it lifted the containers away from moisture. Two, it doubled the floor space of this particular house by creating a roof on top of this particular underside space that was just covered on the open ends to create a big open plan living space. So the fifth foundation type we'll look at is called a timber foundation. I know you are wondering, how can you use a timber foundation for a shipping container house project? So it's not what you think. This is what you do. In this particular type of foundation, we are basically using what I would call timber beams or poles. Yeah. So what you need to do, you need to ensure that the poles or the timber beams you are using are properly treated so that they cannot be attacked by moisture or water, and also you need to treat them from termites. Another thing I need to point out is that recycled telephone and electricity wooden poles are good alternatives you can use for this particular foundation. So, what are the advantages of using a timber foundation? One, a timber foundation is suitable for any soil type. Two, there's no specialized equipment that is required. Another advantage is that it's cheaper than steel and concrete pier and slab foundation. It is also easy to fix utility lines with this particular type of foundation because the space on the underside of the shipping container, and therefore fixing your plumbing lines, becomes easier. This one is also good because it makes good use of recycled materials, and therefore is a sustainable way of doing a green building. What are the disadvantages? One, this one is bad for earthquake-prone locations, a nuisance to you. Another disadvantage is that the elevation of your shipping container is limited by the timber size or the size of the timber pole you are going to use. So the bigger the pole, the bigger the underside space, the smaller the pole, the smaller the underside space. A good case study for this project is the ubiquitous container guest house by Jim Poteet, located in Antonio, Texas, the United States. They have used recycled telephone poles on which this single 40-foot shipping container guest house sits. In summary, the top 5 foundation types you can use for your shipping container house project include 1. A pier foundation, either made from concrete or steel. 2. A slab or a raft foundation. 3. A pile foundation. 4. A strip or a trench foundation. And last but not least, a timber foundation. Did you find our analysis exhaustive and informative enough to help you start your own shipping container house project? Or have you built your own shipping container home? Let us know what type of foundation you used for your own shipping container project. If you feel we have left out something, kindly let us know by posting in the comments below. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up and feel free to share it. Remember to subscribe to our channel for our weekly videos on shipping container house projects. Thank you for your time and see you in the next video.